On today's hiwatt soundbite, we're pulling from the tape vault and exposing some killer vocal effects. Well, I am very excited to share another vocal production session. And, you know, going back and opening up these archive sessions, this is so fun for me. I mean, I purge everything about every 6 months musically, so I don't have a clue what I did to a mix a year ago or 10 years ago. And so digging in and sort of having to open things up and do some investigation, sort of fun in itself. Well, the song we're going to dissect today, I'm really excited about. It's Frontline Assembly's IED. This was the opening track on their 2010 album, Improvised Electronic Device. Now, I've been a big fan of Frontline Assembly for a very long time, so you can imagine how excited I was when the guys reached out to me and asked me to get involved in that album. Well, when the guys delivered the first track to mix, oh man, that excitement level went up 10 notches. You know, this track, IED, has two perfect ingredients for a heavy track. 169 BPM and a 5/4 time signature. The drum beat they've got going against that 5/4 time, and the way Bill delivered his vocals, so well done. Now, for anyone who's familiar with this track, it has like a 2.5 minute intro that happens before the first verse. For today's session, I'm just gonna truncate that. We're gonna focus mostly today on the verses and a kind of B section that happens before the second verse. So for perspective, I've just taken the track back 8 bars before the first verse. I'll play that and we'll go through the verse and just into the chorus, just for perspective. Let's check it out. And yeah, the combination of 169 BPM and 5/4 time signature, I gotta remember that one. That's good. All right, so let's dig right in. I've got all of the vocals grouped to a VCA in this case, so let's listen to just the vocals in that same section.
No future, no life, no sunshine, no rights. No possessions, no sight, no expression, final fight, the anger.
Oh yeah, I just love that vocal process. So let's break this thing down and have a look at what's going on. I can see that I've got a main lead vocal track that I've actually tracked distortion on. So I went back and looked at my old TDM session, and sure enough, I tracked vocal distortion through Amp Farm, this incredibly cool plugin that used to be available back in the good old TDM days. Holy man, whatever happened to Amp Farm and Echo Farm? Two of the greatest sounding plugins ever made, hands down. And they don't exist anymore. Oh my gosh. All right, so there are a few layers making up this sound, but they're all derived from the main two tracks that were supplied to me. So we're talking about a main lead that Bill sang, and then he recorded a double to that main lead. Let's start by listening to this amped out lead vocal track. Here it is by itself.
No future, no life.
Okay, I'm gonna unsolo that and I'll go up and solo our, what I'm calling tracker alt.
No future, no life.
So that is a really cool sounding track, and I know just what that is. It's a vocoder that I use often, my electrics vocoder. It's a physical unit in my rack. And it's got a noise generator in it, which is absolutely wonderful because you can choose not to put anything into the carrier input. In other words, the main stereo input of that vocoder, you just don't send anything to it. It's got an internal noise generator that you can dial up and sort of find a good sounding kind of noise that the tone works into your track. And then of course you feed a vocal to the formant input. In this case, Bill's vocal feeding that formant generates a noise track that follows Bill's voice and the envelope of his vocal, right? Very, very effective, and I use it a lot. Check it.
No. Future.
Now, what's really cool about that is there's no dry feeding through that at all. That's just the noise generator being affected with Bill's voice, right? With that formant input. Okay, so let's check out this third layer.
No. Future. No. Life. No. Sunshine.
Now, I know what that is. That's me vocoding the rhythm guitars with Bill's voice. In other words, Bill's voice is feeding the formant input, and I've got a mix of all these rhythm guitars feeding the carrier signal of that vocoder. I've talked about this in past sessions. This is a very cool and effective vocal effect. Check it.
No. Sunshine. No. Right.
And the combination of all of these together, boom.
No. Future.
Okay, something I've noticed that I've got going on here that I do often when I mix. When an artist provides me with a really solid lead vocal track and a double track, when they put a lot of time and effort into that double and they've really done a good job of it where it's like really locked up to that original main vocal part, I will use that double track to feed all of these cool special effects. In other words, I'll reserve that main powerful lead vocal to be like processed on its own and sitting in the mix in a certain place. Sometimes when you're creating these big, wide, cool stereo effects, it can be so beneficial to feed that effect with the doubled vocal track, not the main lead that you're actually trying to create this effect around. In my experience, this has just always been something that's worked really, really well, particularly when that double track is really performed solid and kind of locked up with that original. You know, in both cases of these layers, they're both vocoded parts, and I'm feeding the formant input with that doubled vocal part, not the lead. It's just something I've found very, very effective over the years, and you should absolutely give it a try, for sure. Yeah, one more time on their own.
No. Life. No.
Just love the relentlessness of this track and the combo of these three layers. They work so well. Yeah, that's just too killer. Okay, so let's cue this track up to this B section that I'm talking about that happens right before the second verse. And again, just for perspective, let's have everything in and let's have a listen to, you know, four bars before this section. Okay, so let's listen to the same thing with the vocal solo this time.
Beg for mercy. Beg for strife. Beg for tomorrow. Beg for sight. War. A call to arms. War. Beat the drums. War. A call to arms. War. Beat the drums.
Now I can see in this B section that I've gone ahead and muted that kind of main vocoded rhythm guitar part that is so effective in the verses. I've got that muted. And I can also see that the double vocal track, the one that I talked about earlier where it's feeding those special effects, well, I've actually got it feeding directly into the mix during this B section. So that double track in the verses is actually not feeding the mix. I've got that channel muted. and the sends that I've got to help out the other effects are pre-fader, of course, so they're still sending. So I noticed that in this B section, I've actually unmuted that track to have it feed the mix. And I can tell I did that for clarity and just really a different kind of vocal sound. You know, I've got that main lethal kind of guitar effect muted, still got that airy kind of sound, still got the main vocal with the distortion on it, but we're adding that doubled vocal track. It really changes it up. Check it out.
Beg for mercy. Beg for strife.
I'm going to add the verse double now.
Beg for mercy. Beg for strife.
And then add that top layer of that kind of noise track.
Beg for mercy. Beg for strife.
Putting a little backwards effect on and every other line here in the first half of this B section. Let's have a listen to that. Well, here's another couple of tracks and something that I do quite often in a mix where I hear something in my head vocally that isn't supplied to me. I'll just go ahead and get my own vocal mic out and I'll just track it, as is the case with this. Yeah, I ended up just doubling the lyric "war" with my own voice. I'm not even sure I shared that with the guys, actually, but here it is on its own.
War! War!
Yeah, you don't even really need to be a singer to do that, right? And so effective in the mix. If I take that solo off and just play those vocals all by themselves again.
War! A call to arms! War! Beat the drums! War!
And I can see for this entire B section that Bill recorded a really high, like, screaming kind of vocal on top. I'll play it all together and then I'll just isolate that track by itself.
Beg for mercy. Beg for strife. Beg for tomorrow. Beg for sight.
Now, I absolutely have to take a second and recognize that one of the contributors and wonderful souls that made up Frontline Assembly is no longer with us. I'm talking about Jeremy Inkle. I wish I got to know Jeremy more than I did, but I can absolutely say that because of, you know, we went out and did a tour together, Frontline Assembly and Skinny Puppy, and Jeremy was a part of that tour. You know, there was something so special about that man. I just never saw Jeremy with anything but a huge smile on his face. So that's a pretty great thing to remember somebody by. I'll just remember Jeremy Inkle's smile for the rest of my life. It was an awesome thing. You know, I've said it in the past, but when I open up these old archive sessions, it's so apparent that they're a really big group effort. You know, we're talking about Bill and Chris and Jeremy and Jared. Oh man, the combined experience that all of those guys have producing this awesome genre of music, man, it's like time to get my notebook out. You see where I'm going with this. It's a lot of effort by a lot of individuals. And then finally, when it all comes together in a mix, now that's something to celebrate. Well, I hope you get inspired to try a couple of these effects in your next mix. And Jeremy, rest in peace, brother.